Hi, welcome to the class. Today is the first class. So as I did in the social class, so before going into the chapter, before going into the grammar, I would like to give the introduction or past story about the English. I don't know whatever the grammars that covered in your 4th standard and in the 5th standard. So that's why the first basic concept of the grammar will be taught in this video. In the next videos, I'm going to the grammar that is given in the textbook, the particular grammar given in the textbook. Is it right? Yeah, and also there is a one famous dialogue that if the lion is stepping back, it does not mean that it is afraid of enemy. So it does mean that it is getting ready to attack on the enemy like that. So if I am teaching you the grammar of your 4th standard or your previous year's grammar, so don't think that I am going back. It is like I am getting prepared to teach you the further grammars that comes in your 5th standard. Is it right? So, I know that today I am going to teach you about the parts of speech. What is the topic of today? Parts of speech. Parts of speech. So this means sometimes in India and in any other languages, the name itself gives the hint. Our name itself tells what the topic is about. Is it right? Yes. Parts of speech. Parts means what? A small, small part. Small division, fragment. Is it right? Speech. Speech means you have heard the word speech often. So in the function, if you are in the function, what they will say, so now the principal will give his speech, or president speech, or inaugural speech, chairperson speech, like that they will give the speech. So and if I am talking for very long time, what they will say, oh he started speech man, like that they will say. Speech means what? A long talk. So what I am speaking, it is also speech. Speech means what? Speaking or giving some information or giving a long talk about topic. These are called what? Speech. So speech means what? Speaking. Speaking means in that we includes more grammar points or grammatical points. So about that we are going to study. Parts of speech. So very small parts of speech. It should be included in the speech. Speech means in our daily language conversation. It should be included. That's why it is called as a parts of speech. So today we are going to study about parts of speech. If you study this concept or if you have already studied this concept, it gives you the strength to speak in English. So that is not only the English, the perfect English with grammatical zero errors. Is it right? So let us see, there are 8 parts. In the parts of speech, there are 8 parts. Let us see one by one which are of those. The first one is noun, second one is pronoun, and the third one is verb, fourth one adverb, fifth adjective, sixth preposition, seventh conjunction, eighth interjection. So these are the 8 parts of speech. So now pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction, interjection. These are the 8 parts of what? Parts of speech. So these 8 are called as what? Parts of speech. Let us go one by one. So in this class or in this video, I am not going to tell you very deeply. I will give some idea about this. If you have not forgotten, so please let me know. I can move on to the next concept. If you have forgotten, so let me know through the WhatsApp messages. I can teach you this daily before going to the grammar that is given in your textbook. Let us see this one by one. First one is noun. So noun means names. For easily understand, what we can think? Names. Noun means names are lady and nun. It is too easily understand. Noun means names of lady and nun. So what is lady? In your science classes, you have studied what is the meaning. The meaning is person or man. Person or people. People means me, you and everybody. Man, kind or human. The names are person. The names are animals. The names are birds. And also you can add here the names of insects, the names of what? Viruses, bacteria, everything you can include. So which are the living and the names of those living things are animals, it is called as noun. And non-living means object or things or what? Places. So here we can understand that noun means the names of a person, names of animals, names of a bird, names of a bacteria, names of a insects, what? The animals which have the me or life. So those names are called as nouns, and also about the non-living things. So names of object, names of things, and names of places. So these are all called what? Noun. What? It is all called noun. For example, if I say in the speech, but Rama is going to the forest. So here what? Rama, I told you, right? Rama is going to forest. So here Rama is a noun. Here Rama Bani Shunga. Here, can you find? So which is noun here? Yeah, Rama is a noun because it's the name of person and Shyamaka. So because it's the name of place, I told. The name of place, person, animals, birds, and object and things, these are called what? Noun. For example, this is a duster. This is also name of a thing or name of object. So that's why duster is what? Noun. Piece of chalk or chalk piece. So this is also name of a object or name of a thing. That's why it is also what? Noun. Will you understand now? So if you don't understand or if you have forgotten in your previous classes, please let me know. I told already that I will teach you in the next classes very deep. So now it is just what? And sometimes, do you know, before going to the new home or before going to the home, the people will brush it. The people will clean after they will enter. Like that. So now what I am doing? So you have already painted, you are already good, but I am not doing, I am just brushing up. Brushing up means what? Brushing up means brushing up your brain to think about or to remember these are the topics. Is it right? So now I told these are the two examples and I told animals. So what are the animals? Dog. So this is the name of an animal. Cat, tiger. So these are the example for noun. And I told bird, parrot, dove, honey. So this is also example. And I told object. What is that object? Pencil. That you are using mobile now. Mumbai. So these are the examples. And for the places, are the place name. Andhra Pradesh. India. So these are the examples for what? Examples for the noun. So these are the names of animals. These are the names of birds. These are the names of object or things. These are the names of places. So that's why these are called as nouns. This is right. We are also naming and non-naming things. If we easily to understand, so we can remember that noun is, so names of our birds, names of a person, names of animals, names of places, and names of the objects. So this is called what? Noun. This is the one function. So I will write one sentence in that you have to find. So which are the noun? So I told in the previous classes only that when you are listening to the video, you have to open your one notebook. And in your hand, there should be a pen or pencil, and you have to write whatever I write on the blackboard, because it is easy to do after I finish the class or after you end the video. If you see the points, you can remember easily. So it is like a hint for you. So if I say the riddle, so what? If you don't know the answer for that riddle, the teacher or the person who said the riddle will give you the hint. Is it right? So like that, if you have copied, or if you can see what I write or what I wrote on the blackboard or what you have written in your notebook, if you see that, so that is a hint for you. After seeing that, you can remember this. Yes, I can remember this. Like that, it will light up your mind. So that's why you have to copy that. So now I am going to write a sentence. Is it right? Okay. Is working in a school is in my school. There she saw a parrot. This is the sentence. In the sentence, you have to find. So, which are the words or noun? So, I am reading that. Tanu is working in a school. School is in my school. So, there she saw a parrot and dog. So, in this, you have to find which are the noun words. Yeah. Tanu is a noun word. Why Tanu is a noun word? So, because Tanu is a name of person, name of a girl, and to school, because this is a name of a building, object. So building is also what? Object. So this is also, and my school is now. Why my school is a noun? Because it is a name of place. And parrot, dog. So parrot and dog is also what? Is also the names of bird and name of animal. So that's why it is also now. Is it clear? And after clearing this, you have to understand here in the writing. Okay, in the beginning of this sentence, I wrote Tanu. In the beginning of the sentence, I wrote Tanu. So later I didn't mention Tanu, but I used she. Is it right? So in the beginning of the sentence, I used Tanu. I'm saying about Tanu, but in the second sentence I used she. So here she means, who is the she here? So she is Tanu. Instead of writing Tanu, I just wrote she. So this is also grammar part. So that's why it is called what? Parts of speech. See, this is one part of a speech. This is one part of a speech. So well, easily I am saying. So this is verb. I told you. Verb is also one part of the grammar, parts of speech. This is what? Preposition. So this is also verb. So like that, see? So in the sentence, I use noun. I use verb. So this is also verb. This is preposition. So this is Pranav. This is also
one.
See, minimum we can use 1, 2, 3, 4. Four kinds of parts. So in this we can include more, but this is sentence basic. So that's why we have used only four grammar line. So now I think you understood about noun. Noun means what? It's a name of place, person, bird, animal, or object. So that's why it's that. So those are called what? Nouns. So now let us see the second part, pronoun. I told that she is a pronoun. So pronoun.
So after that, we will see her.
Name is a person, place, object. Things. This is what? Noun. So pronoun means the words. Pronoun means what? Is also the word used instead of nouns. The words used instead of nouns is called pronoun. Let us see the examples there. So in the later sentence, in the before sentence I wrote that the noun in the beginning, but in the second sentence I wrote she, isn't it? So let us see why it is. So that is what I told, it is a pronoun. So every time we can't use what? Every time we can't use the person of a name, a person of a, the place name, or object name, or things name. So for our easiness, I told parts of speech. Parts of speech means I may speak for more minutes, is it right? So it may be lengthy speech. So those times I cannot use always the names of the person or names of the place. If I say Shomaga, Shomaga in a sentence, so it makes me tired, is it right? It is also not good. Already you know about, I am speaking about Shomaga, then what I can use in this city. In this city means what? I am speaking about this city. This city means Shomaga. So if I am saying that, so he is the bike. If I say the example, so here is, just imagine that here is a bar. Okay, na? I am saying about this. So he is a meat. This is Tarun. I will say Tarun. Next I will say Tarun is studying in the 6th standard. Tarun is a student of Mandara Jnanadaya school. Tarun is living in the Shomaga city. So these are the four sentences. So what Tarun, Tarun, Tarun? It makes like, it makes delay. So to say easily, first I will say his name. So meet, this is Tarun. He is 6th standard and he is studying in the Jnanamandala High School and he is living in this Shomaga city. So see, Tarun, he is very easy to say. And also in a short time I can conclude, I can convey that what I am going to say. So that's why the pronouns are used. See, the pronouns are he, she, he, she, they, it, this. These are the examples for pronouns. These are only the few examples. So he used for name, it is for female, and this is for both. So when it is plural and it for object, and this is also for object. So when the both male and female are together or in a single place, we will use them. In the classroom, passing words will sit together. So I am speaking about them. See, them is also pronoun. So when that time what I will use? They. They means the girls and boys. So both are they. So for this video, I am ending here. So in the next class, we can study more about more types of the pronoun and the next parts of speech. If you can't remember but you have learned in the 6th standard, please let me know. I can go little deeper. If you can remember everything, just tell me. I can just go line by line because we have to complete the grammar that is given in your 5th standard books. So for that, going inside of the grammar, you have to understand. So these are the basic things. If you know, this is the founding steps, or this is the basement, or this is the starting step. If you can easily step on the starting step, you can easily climb the terrace or top. So that's why I am teaching this. So please let me know. Thank you. And also you have to make your key points, and if you can write the examples for now, and also write the example for pronoun, use this in the sentences. Thank you.